Analyst, China maritime militia near Pag-asa threatens PHC air access. Minimus. The presence of Chinese maritime militia near Pag-asa Island, Thito Island, in the West Philippine Sea, South China Sea, threatens the Philippines' aerial and sea routes to the island, an analyst said. Maritime expert Dr. J. Batongbacal said that if China would maintain its constant presence near the island, the Philippine control of Pag-asa and the sandbars close to it would be completely lost eventually. Dozens of Chinese vessels have been maintaining their presence on a daily basis around the Philippine-occupied island in the last 3 months. The military tallied over 600 vessels to have come and gone for the first quarter of 2019 alone, combined with massive PLA and left bracket POKLES Liberation Army Navy right bracket and CCG left bracket Chinese Coast Guard right bracket ships, plus hundreds of PAFM left bracket POKLES Armed Force Maritime Militia right bracket versus China WONT. We then have to touch Pag-asa. They can just cut it off when they want to, Batongbacal said in a Facebook post. In a recent security briefing, Lt. Col. El Pideo Factor of the Western Command said most of the Chinese vessels identified as maritime militia were mostly in the vicinity of Pag-asa sandbars. There are 3 sandbars between Pag-asa and China-controlled Zamora Reef Super Reef, one of China's biggest military outposts in the Spratly Islands. The closest sandbar to Pag-asa, sandbar number 3, is located 22 nautical miles 3.7 km away, while the farthest one, sandbar number 1, is 4.7 nautical miles 8.7 km away from the island. The fishing vessels establish an informal, non-military blockade of Sandy K, cutting it off from access from Pag-asa. Batongbacal said if this situation continues, Philippine control of the area of Pag-asa will effectively be lost and reduced to a near 4 nautical miles, and that piece of territory Sandy K is a high tide elevation will likewise be lost. Pag-asa Island Mayor Roberto Del Mundo said last month that China had been denying local fishermen access to the sandbars, a traditional fishing spot. As early as 2017, there had been reports of Chinese Coast Guard and its fishing vessels blocking Filipino fishermen trying to go to the sandbars. The government laid down these reports. The Philippines' air access to Pag-asa is also a potential risk because of the presence of these Chinese vessels. Those fishing vessels are also directly along the flight path of any aircraft coming into slash out of Pag-asa using the runway. Anyone coming into slash out of Pag-asa fire could be under threat from these fishing vessels, considering TODAY's portable weaponry. Batongbacal explained, the nature of these Chinese vessels is quite tricky. Most of them pose as fishing vessels, but they are not actually fishing. Instead, they have been intimidating other vessels by just maintaining THEIRPRESENCA in the area. This tactic is referred to by experts as gray zone strategy, where the vessels are used to avoid direct responsibility by arguing that these are not government vessels. Sandy K's importance. The Philippines has lodged a diplomatic protest against the illegal presence of the vessels around the island. Such actions are a clear violation of Philippine sovereignty, sovereign rights, and jurisdiction, the Department of Foreign Affairs said. President Rodrigo Duterte has also asked China to lay off Pag-asa, otherwise he would send Philippine troops on a suicide mission, INRESPONSE. But he was quick to clarify that it was a word of advice and not a warning to Beijing. the move is surprising, as the Duterte administration has earned criticisms for its non-confrontational stance in the sea dispute in exchange for economic opportunities and friendly ties with China. In 2017, Duterte said he would not go to war over the sandbars when urged by critics to protest the presence of the Chinese vessels near the island. PRRD left bracket President Rodrigo Roa Duterte right bracket thinks it's not worth fighting over this sandbar. He does not see that if he cedes control of that pile of sand, he will cede aerial access to Pag-asa, directly undermining the Philippines' ability to keep its hold on its largest island in the Kalayaan Island Group and the seat of government of the Municipality of Kalayaan, Batongbacal said. Related/Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.